Oh my God.
I cannot imagine. I cannot imagine. We got more background to this now. Obviously, a scary situation to say the least. CBC reported that a spokesperson for the construction company in charge of the project said that the worker's hand, the hand, was entangled with a tag line after he had attached a load to the crane. So what you're watching is not a person that has a good grip. It's already bad. How can you have a good grip on anything in that situation? But he doesn't even have a grip. His hand is caught in the tag line of this particular load, which means this could have went in a disaster immediately, but it did not. There's a background to this particular construction site. So a video of a worker dangling in midair from a crane at a construction site in downtown Toronto went viral on Wednesday after multiple witnesses filmed the incident, exclaiming things like, oh my God, at the scene and encouraging the man to hang on to the line. The crew was able to safely lower the worker down. He was not seriously injured, CBC News reported. The incident took place on Tuesday at the site that's near Toronto's financial district. Here's some more background. The construction site, located downtown at the corner of Front Street West and Simcoe Street, was the same place where a crane collapsed into an adjacent building July of 2020. Now, let me ask you this, attorney. Is there an actionable claim here? Because I've worked a few construction sites in my life. When you are loading and there's a pickup of the load, there's a protocol to make sure that everybody is clear from the pickup. Obviously, if his hand is still attached to the load, that protocol was not followed. So I'm asking, is this a contributory negligence dynamic, or may he have an actionable claim against a company that looks as if they have a history of things going sideways?
I think your point about him having a history is going to be and ended up being maybe one of the most important points, because they had a safety thing in July 2020. What did they do after that? What kind of protocols, or is this just, you know, this construction site just kind of poorly managed? And as you said, that there's often some jurisdictions are can have comparative negligence, which means maybe the employee's like 20% liable and the company's 80%, or vice versa. If they both maybe made mistakes that can contribute to negligence, I would think in a situation like this, because it is so extremely rare. I mean, there's tons of construction sites, really dangerous, happening all the time. The fact that this is so rare is because there's so many protocols in place, as you say. So almost just by the fact that it happens, probably shows that there was some sort of negligence on the company's part.
Yeah, we're going to follow this one if there's a development as it relates to the employee here. I feel bad for the guy, but I'm glad he's alive.